Hey guys, it's me Sylvia, back with another video, and today we are gonna be doing a story time video. So I don't do very many story times on my channel, but you guys seem to really like them and I'm constantly getting requests. You know when you kind of like forget memories or they fade and then all of a sudden one day something reminds you of it? This happened to me the other day and I literally cannot stop reliving this moment ever since I remembered it. And I cringe so hard every time. I'm still so embarrassed looking back on it. But anyways, I put up a poll on Twitter and asked you guys if you wanted to see another story time. And there was like an overwhelming yes. We're gonna do it today. I'm giving the people what they want. You're welcome. Hit the like button because I'm doing this for you and I'm gonna die of embarrassment all over again for the entire internet to know. Why am I doing this? Anyways, because this is such an embarrassing video and I'm kind of petrified to tell everybody this story, I've got my handy dandy trusty wine bottle to help me tell the story a little bit more comfortably. You know, give me some liquid courage because your girl needs that to tell the story. I already filled up a glass. I may or not be already one glass or two in. So let me just take a big gulp and we'll get on with it. If you're watching this video and you're not subscribed to my channel, please go down and hit that subscribe button because I'm about to share with you the cringiest moment I think of my life so far to date. And I've had a ton of cringy moments, so please subscribe to make me feel more comfortable. We can start being friends. So without further ado, let's get to the story. I'm still gonna put the little swish thing. Swish. 1 second. I think I was 14 or 15 at the time. I don't really know, I don't remember exactly. And my mother had introduced me to her friend's son. Yes, that's what happened. Come on! Okay, there we go. It listens to me. And we had gone over to their house, and as soon as I laid eyes on this boy, I was like, ugh, he is so fine. So I saw this guy and I was legit traumatized at how beautiful he was. And I don't know what it was, but I like immediately had the hots for this guy. And I was like 15. I never really did anything. Like I don't even think I kissed a guy at that point. No, I probably did. I think I did. But anyways, every time Wolfie Jr. makes a noise throughout this video, I'm gonna drink because that's gonna be a lot. Thanks, Wolfie. I regret making that rule. Anyway, so the first time I met him, we just hung out with like him and his family. And after that, like I went home, we legitimately talked like every single day. We texted all the time. Like I was crushing so hard on this guy. I wrote about him in my diary. I dreamt about him. You know, when you're that age, you just get boy obsessed. I'm still boy obsessed, but now it's just with one boy. What was I saying? Every time I forget what I'm saying, I'm drinking too. Oh, I forgot to put lipstick on. Be right back, I'm putting lipstick on before we say anything else because why don't I have it on? 1 second. Update, I realized my lash was coming off too, so I tried to fix it and this is what happened, so no more wine for me, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back and lipstick is on, everything is back in order. I wiped my nose, we're good to carry on. So yes, we would text all the time, we were flirting. It was like the first time that I would like say like dirty things to a boy. Who was I? Like, control yourself, Sylvia. So I was just really into him, okay? That's the point. I was into him, really into him. I think his dad was like into my mom, so he would always encourage her to like bring me over to like play with the kids, you know? So I guess he could like see her. Like, what if my mom and him actually worked out and we ended up becoming step siblings? So my mom would always like drop me off and they had like a really big house and like a jacuzzi and a pool and this and that. So I went there and they told me to bring like a bathing suit so we can go in the jacuzzi and like the pool and stuff. So I went over and I brought my bikini, you know, it was my cutest bikini that I owned. Your girl had to look snatched for the jacuzzi, okay? Bruh. But I'm gonna stop right here and give the guy I liked a fake name. I'm gonna call him Adrian, even though if he's watching this, like he's probably gonna know it's about him. So I took my bikini, went over to their house, and his siblings and I just ended up watching TV. And we wouldn't sit next to each other because we didn't want like his siblings to know that we were texting and like we liked each other or anything, and especially not his dad because we kind of had a feeling that he like liked my mom. So we were keeping it on the DL. So we were like watching TV, sitting on separate couches, just like looking at each other like occasionally. And I was just like waiting for the moment for somebody to be like, hey, let's like go in the jacuzzi because I wanted to whip this bathing suit out. I wanted to put it on, look all cute, body on fleek. At 14, like calm yourself. What are my hormones saying, you know? So anyways, somebody was like, hey, let's go in the jacuzzi. I was like, okay, like I piped right up, you know? So I went and got changed. And here's where it begins, you guys. The traumatizing jacuzzi moment. So being a girl, having insecurities, especially at that age, I was really insecure about my small boobs. I wanted to like impress him and I didn't want him to be like turned off by me or anything, you know, okay? So that's what was going through my mind. I was just really insecure and I wanted to look good. So what I did, I don't even know what they're called, but a lot of the times they're stuffed in like bras to make them more push up. And for some reason, I thought it would be a good idea to take these from my bra and put them in my bathing suit. Mind you, this was an itty bitty tiny bikini. So I did that thinking like, what's the worst that can happen? My boobs are just gonna look amazing. No, Sylvia. So I took them from my bra and I stuffed them in my bikini. And what it is made of, it's like a spongy material and it just goes in your bra usually and it just gives the girls a little bit more perkiness, you know? So I put those in my bikini and I was ready to go in the jacuzzi. So the three of us just went in the jacuzzi. It was him and his sister. His brother didn't come. So we're in the jacuzzi. He was like looking at me. I was looking at him. And we were just like trying to have light conversation with his sister. Everything was going great until, 1 second, I'm out of wine. And this is the part where I needed the most. All of a sudden, like something's floating in the middle of the jacuzzi. Yeah, you know what it was. You know exactly what it was, okay? Here it comes, just floating in the jacuzzi. So I guess like the jacuzzi jets forced it out of my bikini and like it escaped. It escaped my bikini and was now in the open water for everyone to see. I didn't even notice it, okay? It was floating in the middle of the freaking jacuzzi and I didn't notice it. All of a sudden he's like, guys, what's that? And I looked at it and I was like, I knew exactly what it was. Of course I did. But I was like, oh, ew, what is that? And he like takes it and he holds it and he's like, what is that? And he's like looking at me, looking at his sister. So I'm like, I don't know what that is. And I look at his sister and I'm like, is it yours? Yeah. Yeah, I'm a shady ass girl, okay? Don't be friends with me because I'm about to blame you for my boob flotation device that floats in the pool. I'm gonna blame it on you and try and embarrass you. And she's like saying that she doesn't know what it is. I'm saying I don't know what it is. And I feel like she honestly didn't know what it was because she was a couple years younger than me and I don't think she was like into the whole push-up bra thing yet. He's like squeezing it. He's like, what could this be? Why is it in the jacuzzi? He's like, the jacuzzi was just cleaned and he's like squeezing it. The entire time I was so mortified, but I was like trying to chuckle it off. I was like, what could it be? Like, I don't know, your jacuzzi is pretty dirty. So he takes it and like chucks it out of the jacuzzi. So one boob has like the cushion in it still, and the other boob is just like the regular size. Okay, flat, you know? I did not want him to find out that it was mine. Like, I felt like if I got up, like, you could obviously tell that one of my boobs is smaller than the other, and he would figure it out. I was, like, making sure I was in the jacuzzi, like, low under the water, making sure no one could see my boobs. Whereas before, I was, like, flaunting it, you know? So I just tried to change the subject after that, and I was, like, crossing my arms and making sure I was staying in the water. All of a sudden, his sister gets up and is like, I'm gonna go inside now, like, my show is on or whatever. Like, I think she wanted to go watch her show. She got up and she walked inside and this normally would be an ideal situation for me. Like I would be like, yes, no third wheel. But because of what had happened and I was like lopsided, I didn't want to be alone with him because I was worried he would try and like feel me up and feel that my boobs are completely different sizes. So now that his sister went inside, obviously he's gonna try and like make a move. He kept like inching closer to me. So as he was inching towards me, I was like inching away. And luckily for me at this point, his dad kept coming to the window that was in front of the jacuzzi and like checking on us. Cause I feel like he didn't want anything to happen between us. And I was like, no, like it's your dad again. Like we don't wanna do this in front of your dad. Like get away from me pretty much because I'm like, don't touch my boobs. So I convinced him that I'm bored of the hot tub and that I want to go inside and his dad kept looking at us. He was like, yeah, fine. Like we'll go in the basement and just like watch a movie. But this is when the next obstacle presented itself. Okay, I had to get out of the jacuzzi, which meant he would be able to see that one boob is bigger than the other. And because these little cutlet things were like sponge material, they obviously absorb so much of the water that when I stand up out of the water, it like leaks. At that point, I realized I'm like, what am I gonna do? One boob is bigger than the other. So I like slowly get out of the water and I'm like cross-armed and I'm squeezing down on the boob that has the little sponge cutlet in it and it's like wringing out the water and I'm like, okay. And I walk in the house like arms crossed pretending I'm cold. I'm a genius at this point. I'm like, oh, I'm so cold. Gotta cover my boobs. So we walk inside, get our towels, and I was safe. Safe. Boobs were covered. My cutlet was gone somewhere in the bushes. At least he doesn't know that I was trying to like enhance my boobs for him, you know? I didn't tell anybody. I was just so embarrassed. I really hope that he actually had no clue what it was. I don't even remember what ended up happening with him and I. I feel like he just lived far away and our texts kind of fizzled out and that's all there was to it. So I'm gonna end the story there. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. Bye.